We're gonna do this. I'm Sukuma. I come from AKRS BMI.
Actually, we have been promoting SRM as a practice from 2005 onwards. And based on our experience for past years, we have tried to analyze how adoption has been played a role in our promotion. So that we have tried to investigate in this paper. This is a program area of ours. Though we work in three states, this study is focused towards the tribal subcultural region, which is almost 7 districts we cover, which is predominantly with the tribal communities. So we work with tribal farmers actually. And the norms, though there are a lot of combination of norms in SRM, we as a POP have developed as a 5 practices which we followed and implemented during our SRI implementation. First, standardizing age to 10 to 14 days, and spacing 25 to 25, and seedlings 1 of course, and water management, alternate drying matting that is mandatory, and weeding at least twice. These are the norms which we have set as a perfect SRI practices. Then towards the implementation, some of the process which we follow is like attendance campaigns, is like a normal extension process, and field-based trainings and demonstration at fields, and information designation through resource farmers. Resource farmers are those who are experienced and progressive farmers who can afford for large farmers mostly, who have been, who don't have any restrictions in following better practices. And those who are interested in promoting to other farmers also. Those farmers we have taken to promote it to other farmers. Those are like volunteers. And of course, extension volunteer model we have to extend our agriculture program. And exposure visits. Of course, these are the general extension model we follow for all our agriculture programs. Then coming down to our objective of the study, we are interested in documenting factors in continued adoption. Why and how it is, what are the factors which are affecting them in continued adoption, and what are the subset of practices they are retaining, which has been successful in following this. Though we have said 5 practices, which are those subset of practices which have been mostly followed, that we have tried to analyze, and how this yield in the same plot of land has been addressed in this actually. How we have been proclaiming that SRI has been giving more production, but how in same plot has that been, like we have tried. And the methodology is like population we have covered, as we said, our tribal belts, Gedepada, Sagpara is in Navada. Navada district, Wali of course Baruch, and Malvi of course in Surat. These are the areas which we have tried, and we have taken only those farmers with whom we have worked with. Those farmers we have taken, and sampling of course we have stratified sampling with the 331 sample size, and we have made interview schedules. This was done during of February and March. And this is a classification we have made out of our sample 331. Mostly covered with marginal farmers, 2 of 7 actually, and mostly with the disruptors and adopters. This category we have made in a bit tricky. Like adopters, we have taken those who have continuously done SRI practice for 3 years. And we have taken disruptors like those who have dropped in any of these 3 years. We have classified them as disruptors. This disruptors term is a bit tricky, but this is like, there could be cases like, they were not totally dropped this, but there could be cases of discontinuing this practice for any of these years also.
You could have called them partial disruptors or something.
Exactly.
This adopter is a little...
Exactly, yeah. And sample size, again we have tried to classify the doctors and disruptors into irrigated and rain-fed practices. Sample size being in adopters, irrigated farmers. And land, average land holding being 1.3 hectares. But I see this paddy cultivation area is almost an acre. Almost in all the cases, it is almost an acre. And migration as we have tried actually, by migration, see, interestingly, even adopters to irrigators, there has been more. This is one of the reasons that we could find is like they get sufficient production quota, food security is there, then obviously people move out for more income actually. So distress migration has reduced, but they have, it is like voluntary going out for more income. That type of finding has come in. And of course, education is very low, is a tribal belt, so almost like fifth standard. And coming to our paddy cultivation practices, we are trying to analyze one by one, step by classification. Like seed application, like 2 kg per acre. Among the adopters, only 48% of 48 or most have been using this practice. But if you see the average, if you see 4.8 is the average, that being least. But in other rainfed and other rainfed is more. Reason is in before our intervention, the usage of seeds have been almost 40 kg per acre. And now that change has not, though we say 2 kg, that sudden change can happen immediately. That's insecurity being using 40 kg and immediately shifting to 2 kg becomes a bit insecure. So they obviously go for more seed actually. And mostly they are using hybrid seeds. And spacing also, adopters being more like irrigators. And transportation age, as we have adopters and irrigators. And transportation age, of course, even in transportation age, though we have 10 to 14 days as a norm, average if we come to that, it is almost something. We'll come, yeah. What availability?
Mortality.
See, yeah.
First starting there is mortality.
Okay, yeah. And ceiling per hill, this is also adopters, irrigators are coming. And if you see average, it comes to 1, almost nearing to closing to 1 actually. And the weeding practice, again, doctors have taken the maximum role here. Water management, again, irrigators have managed water then. And cap expenditure, this is a and if you see, interestingly, cash expenditure among irrigators is more. One of the reasons which we find is irrigators use more fertilizers. The use of fertilizers is more by this than which increases cost of production actually. And average paddy yield, as we have tried, which is almost difference being irrigators and non-irrigators being around 50%, 40-50% it comes in. And when you see the extent of difficulty following excellent practices, we have just made some rating and based on that, the other scores we have taken. If you see the, this one, spacing by disruptors and water management by rainfed has been observed as a major of the five-point scale, has been noted down as a significant difficulty levels. And coming to constraints, we have sort of some areas like down in overall SRA techniques and lacking technical support. This is like we have tried whether they have, why they are not followed, whether it is our extension approach or their knowledge level. But if you see doubt, that is very least, and lack of technical support is also very least. But if you say availability of water about the rainfed and of course about labor issues, labor during transportation age, this has been a major constraint among the sub-practice. And again, even our extension approach, just to give incentives, we have been doing 250 rupees. We give this 250 rupees in two phases, just to increase this practice. So we tried whether that is really a motivating factor for them, but when we tried out, that has become very least, that is not a much factor. But higher production has been a major motivation factor across the adopters and disruptors. And the rainfed conditions, that also has among rainfed farmers, there have been fruit with 3.6, because even in rainfed conditions also, we can do SRF factors in schools. And very small actually, there are combinations that we have put in this way. We have tried some subset of practices. This is actually, we have taken it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as 1. So this is the numbers which we say are actually the practices. Spacing is for 1, transpiration for 2, average dry budding 3, seeding per hill 4, and weeding as 5 actually. If you see the set of practices, 4 and 5, but those are falling only 4 and 5 as per our 14%. That is seeding per hill and weeding, those are falling back alone or 14%. Whereas if we add spacing also, they are being 11%. And just leaving transpiration alone, 1, 3, 4, 5, there are the maximum 36. So if you see the set of practices, transpiration has been a major, transpiration age has been a major problematic area in combination of practices. And even if you see all the practices, only 9% of the whole adopters have followed strictly those practices, 5 practices. But all others are monetary practices. And with our this experience of what has come and with this group discussions, we came across like wooden markers. Of course, rightly discussed, rightly said, the soil conditions matter a lot. Because in our program, yeah, this is a very hot even markers don't get into that. But this we tried with some irrigated farmers. This has worked out this year. But this we are also planning to make it with some period actually, not with every time, but with some farmers we are trying out this recommendation. Just maintain this spacing. And next is the rice bed preparation. What happens is the major problem is monsoon delay. Delayed monsoon is expected by mid of June every year. What happens is in that anticipation they make this bed preparation by the mid of when it starts 2-3 days before, like 12th of June they make it. But if that rain fails, then definitely they will not be able to follow that. Stay 10 to 14 days. So just to make that, we have suggested like if you make it in 3-4 days gap, like in first week they will have 2 kgs, make it to 3 parts and make it in phase wise. First 4 days they will make it this, after the 5th day they will make second, and it is matter of 2 weeks difference which makes better. If you see the transcription age, 10 to 14 days is fine, but the average is 17. So it is just a matter of a week. So if that 4 days phase out, then they can make up that age also. That is one of the suggestions we have tried. And Kolo-Vidar, of course, Kolo-Vidar we have promoted with group of 5. This time we have doing it. This is two reasons. One is since what made us not to use it till now is the soil conditions. We have tried with 2-3 models of Kolo-Vidar which first thing is they are not maintaining the spacing. So this Kolo-Vidar itself is restrictive in cutting those seedlings. That was one. And second is the soil conditions. There is no putting that. But now we are just trying out with this one, with small Kolo-Vidar. And this we have seen this is encouraging even to maintain the spacing also. Now. And one more as a strategy, what we have done is the mistake what we have observed is we have been giving this promotion only for 1 year. One time only they give support, I mean as a training we give. But we think there is a need to give a continuous support for 3 years at least to follow how the next year he the same farmer would be doing it. So if we make it for continuous 3 years, then probably the adoption rate will go high. That's it.
Do you want to add something?
Thank you.
All questions. Thank you very much.